In this video, we're continuing on with the More Nuts of Solids worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the Geometry section. Now, we're picking up on the second page where we're to sketch the net of each solid, and then we're going to label the measurements that are given onto that net. So in number 9, you can see that we have a cone. Therefore, we're going to have a circle as the base. And it tells us that the radius is 4, so we'll go ahead and label that now. And it tells us that the diameter is 4, so we'll label that now. The only thing left of the cone is the lateral area, which will have an arc that connects, to that circle base, and then it will form together, which has an arc that stems out from that circular base, and then two straight lines that connect at the apex. And we're going to label that edge as 8.2. Now let's move on to number 10. In number 10, we have a rectangular prism, where the larger rectangle, the 16 by 19 rectangle, is the base. So we'll start by drawing that base. And this is a rough sketch, so feel free to use a ruler if necessary. Then we'll have one of the other edges, one of the other faces, and then the large base again. So we have this side, that base. Now we just need the three other sides. And now we'll label appropriately. This is 19, 19. This is 16. This is also 19. 16, 19. And the height is 6. So you can see that if you were to fold this up, 19 would touch 19 at the edges. Let's continue on to number 11. In number 11, we have another rectangular prism. However, this time, we'll use 16 by 8 as the base. So this side is 8, and this will be 16. Now in order to get to the other base, we will have to draw that small face that is 5 by 16. So here we have 5 by 16, and then we can now draw our other base on the other side. 16 by 8. And now we have 1, 2, 3 other faces. Two of them, however, are congruent figures, an 8 by 5. So since this length is 5, Here we'll draw our 5 by 8. And again, we'll have our 5 by 8. And then lastly, we need a 5 by 16. And that is the net of number 11. In number 12, we have another cone. So we'll start with the circular base. The radius is given to us in this cone, and that is 9. And now let's draw the rest of the cone, the lateral area. We have an arc extending out from our circle, and it's going to be connected with 2 lines that come together to form the apex. And the length of that is 26.6. Now in numbers 13 through 16, we're going to sketch the solid that can be created from each net. And then we're going to label the measurements on that solid figure. So number 13, looking at this net, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 separate sides on our base. So this is going to be a pentagonal prism. So we'll start with the edges that we can see, and the edges we won't be able to see will be dashed lines. So I'll draw the 2 sides in the back of the pentagon. There is my pentagon. Now my apex will be right here. So I'll have this side coming up connecting into the apex, this side connecting into the apex, this side connecting into the apex, then my front 2 sides connecting into my apex. So I have an edge at each corner. Where the line goes up and meets the apex. Now I'll go ahead and label in a different color so that you can see. The side length of one edge is 14. The slant height or slant length is perpendicular to one of those edges, and that is 20.4. And I have an apothem. Of 9.6. There is my pentagonal pyramid. In number 14, we have a cone, which I think is a little bit easier to draw than the pentagonal pyramid. We'll start with the base, that is a circle. And then we'll connect the edges of that circle up to form the cone. The diameter was given to us as 20, and the length is 22.4. Moving on to number 15, we have a cylinder. So we have two circles as the basis, one. Two, and then I'll connect those circles with straight lines. Then I'll label my height, which is 10, and my radius of 12. And lastly, a rectangular prism. I'll start with the largest face, 10 by 18, and there's two of those. So I have one, ten by 18, and the height is 5. So the distance between those bases is 5. So I'll draw 5 here, 5 there, and then 5 coming out from this bottom corner. And I'll make that dashed so you can see the 3D shape. I'll connect these two points in order to form one of my side faces. Then I'll connect the two top points First, I'll connect these two points in order to form a face on the side. Then I'll connect my two top points to form another face. And that's my solid figure, but let me continue so that you can see the faces in the back. I'll connect this point to this point with a dashed line. And I'll connect this point to this point with a dashed line. And that is my 10 by 18 by 5 rectangular prism in number 16. So here's face 1. This was face 2. Here we have face 3. 4 was my other base. 5 was my bottom face. And then 6 was my other side face. So I made the solid numbers are the faces that are in the front, whereas the dashed numbers were the faces in the back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. And if you haven't already, like this video and subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated. And if you want to, just leave me a note in the comments below, and don't forget to share this with your peers.